it's all fun and games until it spits the rods on the road.
Hi guys, I'm Jordan from Ramblin' Around. I'm currently wearing Cletus McFarland's merch, but you should check out ours as well because we do sell some cool t-shirts and stuff. I figured I would take today to do kind of an overall video of my C10 muscle truck clone and just show you kind of what I've assembled over the last few months. But real quick before we get into it, if you're not already, please like and subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the little bell because, you know, YouTube has a bell now and it's stupid. But go ahead and hit that so you can stay tuned for future content on this. And let's go ahead and take a look. This is actually a 78, but I did put the earlier model grill in there because that's what the muscle truck has, and I scoured the internet until I found a real 454 grill, so it is the same as the OG muscle truck. I did have to make some custom brackets in there to make that work, because obviously it's not right for this front end, but I like that a lot more than what it had, so I'm good with that. That is just a beat up front bumper, but who cares? Theirs isn't perfect either, so it's good enough for me. I did find this nice salvage hood, which has been creased all the way through and then had brackets welded in it to prevent it from happening again, but it is the right color and I actually really like the junkyard marks on it there. I did go through the trouble of putting these arrow catch hood pins on it just because I think it's funny to have modern technology on this junk beat up dented hood with the peeling paint and the junkyard numbers. This would probably scrub off, but I plan on leaving it all because I think it's funnier. But yeah, so I'll go ahead and get the other one open and then we'll take a look at the engine. For those of you that don't know, this is a 6-liter LQ9. This is a Gen 3 engine and it's got a Holley dual plane intake with a phenolic spacer that's a 1/2 inch, and then it has a 1/2 inch NOS sniper kit, and then above that is a quick fuel Slayer 750 carb with a cheap filter. Does have like a Holley 4150 style bracket over here for the return springs and stuff. Inside of this engine, I did do a sloppy stage 3 cam, which is a 595 lift, 238, 242 on a 112. So decent sized cam. I put some pack 1219s with new valve seals in there, and it's been really fun. Does have shorty headers, some upgraded plug wires, and then a swap pan as well. So, but I'm very happy with the performance out of it. The truck is being powered by a MSD box. That's a 6014 box, if I recall. It's an LS series box that comes with some preset tunes. I haven't gotten in there and messed with anything yet, so it's just running on the truck HO setting, I believe. But it seems to like it so far. I also have a catch can there, just loosely self-tappered to the old air conditioning box setup, and then I have a vacuum reservoir over here because the cam does not make good vacuum at all, so that's to help the brakes. And then over here I've got my Mallory fuel regulator. It's a return style, so I have a full length return and then it comes off and goes into that. The nitrous is just teed off right here and then goes to the nitrous solenoid down there, which is some guys are going to be like, ugh, but I've had good luck doing that. Up to like 150 shot of nitrous, it seems fine. So I am just running a 125 shot on it currently, but the engine would probably take a 200, but I don't want to, you know, a 125 is sufficient. It'll be fine on that. And I'm already having plenty of fun with it in A. So it's a fun truck. I will take a jab at the roadkill guys. On motor, this is actually faster than the real muscle truck with their LS6, so at least I can claim that.
And they were on slicks, and this is on street tires, and it's still quicker.
Yeah.
So.
So not bad. but anyway, I guess we'll move on to the truck does have some Indy 500s. They're Firehawks. They're on some rally wheels, just stock truck wheels. I did put a brake upgrade up front. It's basically just a replacement of what it would have had, but it has discs, brand new kit up there, as well as all new ball joints, newer upper control arms, all new polyurethane bushings, stuff like that. So I upgraded all of the suspension up front. It is sitting on Beltec drop shocks as well, all the way around, because the truck, although is still a little taller than I would like it, has been lowered quite a bit, so I thought maybe that would make it ride a little bit better, and so far it has. It does seem a lot smoother than I thought it would. The exhaust is pretty complicated to explain here, but basically one side of a cutout opens into a turbo muffler, which is quieter, and then the other side passes through a bullet muffler, which is very not quiet. It has a 3-inch X pipe going up to the shorty headers that come off of 45 and go straight into that system. So I can choose between putting around town and it just sounds like an old farm truck with turbos, or I flip a switch and it's pretty radical through that bullet muffler. So I like the ability to choose, though. That is nice. Now the real muscle truck itself, I think this is brown and then this is darker gray. This isn't a one-to-one. I liked the blue a little bit more, so I sprayed this blue. Then I put a little white pinstripe on here. I just like the look of it, and I don't want to be 100% exact to theirs. I'm not really that concerned, so I actually like the way this looks, and I plan to just leave it like that. Back here, I did put a wood bed floor in it. This is just one that I cobbled together. It doesn't have the strips or anything like that. It is pine as well, because I was trying to save weight. and I did. The truck actually weighs 3620, which isn't bad for what it is. And considering that's a cast iron LS, short block anyway. I do have a custom wrap on my NOS bottle. It says Gap Daniels Tennessee Gap Sauce. I got that from 1320 Graf Hicks down there. It actually is decent quality and wasn't too expensive if you guys want one. And then I have a 15-gallon RCI, I believe, fuel cell back there that I've plated with stickers from people that I've bought stuff from in typical fashion. And then that feed line on the bottom down there goes down to a Walbro 255, and then from the 255 obviously goes up to the Mallory regulator in the engine bay. The Herzog sticker there is from Doug Herzog. He gave me a big stack of them. He runs Herzog Motorsports. Really cool dude. He's been racing since the 70s, been around a long time. But he built the Turbo 400 for me that is in this right now, and it's pretty substantial. I'm not going to go through and list everything that's in there, but it's totally fine for this truck that's probably making mid-fives on nitrous. But yeah, really good dude. So far, I can vouch for that guy's work. This thing ships amazing, and I've been beating on it, and it's taken everything. So I did do the same taillights that the muscle truck has right there. I did pony up for the new Chevy tailgate here, which actually wasn't quite right for what I had going on, so I just cut it and made it work. again, this thing's just for fun. I'm going to leave it black. I have no plans on painting it, but I did put it on. It does work. Over here, I basically just put a little pin through it, hood pin, so that it keeps it from falling down. So that's not going anywhere. I don't have a hitch set up on it or anything yet, although I probably will put one on there at some point. The rear end is a truck 12-volt that I put 373, I believe they're motive gears in it. And then it has an Eaton posi unit that I also put in there. I can't remember how many splines are on the axles from the factory, but I think they were like 31 or something. Like, they're plenty for what I'm doing. But yeah, so the rear end has been gone through. I went through the drive shaft as well, replaced all the U-joints. And then again, over here, this is what makes it the muscle truck, is the orange fender with the black spray paint. So just trying to kind of go for what they were going for a little bit. But again, it is different here and there, so.
This side looks pretty exact to the muscle truck. It's the other side where he kind of took liberties and did what he wanted, you know.
And the interior is full of junk because I've been driving it like crazy for the last little while, but it does have a bench seat. I put a cover over it. It's got the big tack in it. Like a Daytona style steering wheel and a custom shifter and stuff. So we can throw some photos in of that from when it was actually clean. And I haven't been getting in it with my muddy work boots. But that's pretty much going to do it. We luckily got a good spot out here. Hopefully these people's that are living in these houses directly behind us don't mind us sitting here and filming this, but
we'll probably fire it up without the cutouts just for a little idle clip, and then we're going to get the heck out of here quickly.
Yes. We were lucky enough to pass one of the local police officers, and he did not whip it around and come get us after all of the other dumb stuff that we've done for this video today, which is silly because about a tenth of it is going to make it into the actual video. So what you see is much less than what there was. But you should know that we only do it where there are absolutely no cars on the road. We do try to find private driveways where we know the people, or field roads where there's just no houses. But anyway, that's going to do it, and we'll see you guys in the next one. Stay tuned. I've got some awesome news coming on my GTO. Probably within the next 2 months or so, you're going to see. That's going to be pretty badass. I'm excited to show you guys. So we'll see you guys in the next one. If you're not already, please like and subscribe, and we'll see you later. Bye. We're currently arguing about whether to open the cutouts in this beautiful, tranquil park for the idle clip before we leave. I said no. He says yes. I guess we'll just get the ticket.